All right, what's going on, everybody? First, let me start off by saying I'm sorry for last week. The trending topics video that I did for last week, we all were here last week, but I was actually going to transcribe the video on Monday, totally fucking slipped my mind. So if you guys missed the trending topics from last week, I'm sorry. Totally slipped my mind, totally forgot to upload it. So hopefully I get my shit right. Look, I've been off for the last 2 weeks. My mind has been somewhere else, but I told y'all January was gonna be a rough month for you boy. So I said, charge it to my heart. So, just don't be mad at me, okay? Like I said, I am trying to do better. I know there's a couple of segments that I didn't start that I ain't what's up that I've been slacking on. So y'all have to forgive me. Okay, so please forgive me. And what I'm gonna do, what's up, boo? I will do my damnedest. As soon as this is done, I'm going to put my phone on airplane mode. I will transcribe this video and I will have it up to you too, if not tonight, tomorrow. Because if not, because I don't want what happened last time, like last week, to happen this week, okay? So, with that being said, welcome you guys to Tabloids and Trending Topics with T. And let me first start by saying I don't have a lot to talk about, but I think with what I got to talk about, we gonna have a good time now. This shit was. Oh, okay, all right. Well, thank you. Now here's the thing: the shit I gotta talk about so good, I had to get me this big ass, plastic mason jar feel of Long Island. That's how good this shit is, and I'm gonna need for y'all to sit here and tag on in. If y'all have not invited people, if y'all haven't shared this on Twitter, I recommend that you do it, okay? Cause y'all know I'm talking about that Kanye Amber and hello, y'all know I'm talking about that Kanye Amber and Wiz, but I'm gonna say that for tail end. Now I'm gonna say that for tail end, but we gonna talk about some shit right quick, okay? Hello, so. Actually, let me go ahead and sip and blow right quick. Hold on. Y'all some throwback tea spilling. Okay, so first up is Amina. Now, again, I have yet to do a trending topic and not have to talk about some type of reality TV bullshit. Okay, so Amina, like I said, they're taping the reunion for Love and Hip Hop New York right now. It is alleged that Amina is pregnant yet again by Peter Guns. Now here, this is where shit gets a little bit iffy and everything. Oh well, good afternoon to you too. Now, so here's where shit gets a little iffy. So you can't. I can't either. I can't either. She get the most play on this segment because I don't talk about her ass on the normal motherfucking videos. Nah. But oh yeah, I'm gonna talk about that too. So apparently she's pregnant, and that bombshell got dropped. This is all alleged. Got dropped during the taping of the reunion. But in seeing her in this red dress, you can see a bump. Now, word on the curb is she never aborted her child. Word on the curb is she used it as a way to kind of like, I guess, reel Peter back in. I don't think she did either. So it's one of those where it's like, would you really be showing this far along? You know what? Storyline is right. And I don't, it's one of those where it's just like, is it truly to keep him? Yeah, I know what. Yeah, I know. Okay, my now, here's the thing. This is what I speculate. I don't believe she had the abortion. Now, is it possible that she could be, because we don't know how far along she, because again, all of this is alleged. We won't know until the reunion happens. But it's one of those where I find this to be very, very awkward. And if she is, now, if she did have an abortion and she got pregnant again, it's just so everything, well, first and foremost, everything she's been saying on this platform has been ass backwards. Okay, you're not familiar with Amina Butterfly of Love and Hip Hop New York? Don't be, cause she really not worth it. But I really just don't have much to say, cause it's just like, just talking about them in general is fucking exhausting. And then, of course, I'm getting tired of seeing Tara, you know, parade her. Let me move this down just a little bit. Parade her, pregnancy around. We'll find out in the reunion. So when the reunion comes, we'll see how far along she is and exactly how all of this build up, how all of this manifested itself. We will find out then. Hello, hello. So, before I move on, you tell her, how do you, like, do y'all think that, well, one, what's y'all feelings on this? Do y'all think that she actually had the abortion? Do you think that, she, you know, she didn't? She just went and got pregnant again? Did she do it for a storyline, ratings? What do y'all think? I mean, it's pathetic, but again, first and foremost, we don't know for sure if she's pregnant, one, and two, I suspect she never had an abortion. Again, everything is going to come out, but, and it's even rumored that Peter is not going to come back to Love & Hip Hop New York next year. That's also some shit I've been hearing. I heard that maybe like several months ago that he probably would not come back, which if that's the case and he doesn't come back, then what storylines will Peter, Tara and Amina have? Okay. So I'm going to talk about one more thing before we get to the big shit. Okay. He does. So let's go ahead and talk about Miss Riri. I did not. Is the picture of her in the red dress? Because if it's her in the red dress, I've already seen it. I will have to check out what Much Love has. Again, if I don't know, because if she, like I said, because if she did not abort the baby and she went and told her stepdaughter that, I mean, it's a foul move, but. You know, it is what it is. You know, again, that Tito. Having to sit here and fight, try to find a damn straw. What the fuck? Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about Riri. So her album, Anti, has dropped. Do I have the album? Yes. Do I have title? No. Y'all fill in the blanks, however y'all so choose. Have yet to listen to the album because I am fucking busy. Y'all see that I'm even 30 minutes late coming on camera today. Y'all know a motherfucker is busy. So at some point I will listen to the album. I'm not sure if I will do a review. I may or I may not. I don't know. But I mean, I'm hearing, you know, good things. Oh shit, it's whack. Damn. Okay. All right. I'm talking about Miss Rihanna. Yes, yes. Talking about her. So her album has dropped. Like I said, I am going to give it a good listen. I'll try today. If not, it will be sometime this upcoming weekend because things hopefully will slow down for me. Hopefully. So now here's the thing. The album supposedly leaked before it was actually supposed to. Okay, it's pretty solid. Okay. Now, the whole leaking of the album, it was a system error. I saw 2 out of 5. It was a system error. Now, everybody is just like, fuck a system error. Beyonce leaked that shit. I'm just like, damn. I'm like, okay. Now, if that's the case, I don't really check that much for, you know, Bianca or, you know, Riri. So I don't know what the fuck been going on. I don't know if there's any beef that we don't fucking know about. But it's rumored that Beyonce leaked the album. But they're chalking up as a system error. I know system error. So. Oh, I mean, well, she has been coming out with the album. Like, it's been rumored that she was coming out with the album for a while. And in addition to that, it was also a rumor that she was going to drop the album on Christmas. But I think somebody told her just like, because one of those where it would have got some publicity, but it probably would have went left real quick. She could have leaked it herself. She could have. But here's where the shit gets a little bit interesting. So, that wasn't an error. The album has gone platinum in a short period of time. Now, you have to look at it this way. Exactly. Well, I'm not gonna say that. Well, it's a giveaway, yes, but I'm assuming that if you have Tidal, you were able to go ahead and download the album. So of course, everybody's gonna go ahead and download it. Nobody spent their coin. Well, here's the thing: it went platinum, and a lot of people were upset about that because they felt that it was so inflated. But where a lot of the shit is coming from is Billboard is not recognizing her album. She, hey, look, I'm just here to report it. Okay. Oh yeah, Tidal is still around. Tidal is still around, and the reason that Billboard won't recognize the album is because, you know, they have a policy that does not count free albums. So because, like I said, those albums were technically free, Billboard's not going to recognize it, which means that her album has yet to chart on the Billboard charts. So it's certified platinum. Billboard just isn't recognizing it. And there, like I said, it's available now on iTunes. Okay, the deluxe edition. The deluxe edition, I believe, has three additional songs. The physical copies will be out February 5th. And for those who have Tidal, I think they already have the download. If I'm not mistaken, if anybody on here has Tidal, please let me know. But I think that for those who, oh, hold on. I mean, you know. Yeah, they're not gonna recognize for him. I mean, Dell is killing it, but see, y'all just made me lose my train of thought. Dang, nabbit, y'all. Yeah, I lost my train of thought. Damn you guys. So, before I move on to the bulk of what we're gonna talk about today, what are y'all's feelings on and about Anti being leaked, going platinum, and Billboard not recognizing it? Oh, I mean, of course Adele does. I mean, but if we gonna talk real shit, Adele has talent. There's not that many artists out today that can perform. You know, like, you have some artists that can give you a show. They can give you a little 1-2 step, but still bless you. You know what I'm saying? You have artists that fuck dance, and I'm gonna just stand here and I'm gonna give you straight vocals. Then you have other artists where, you know, they have a little some, but they're all about the show, the glitz, the glamour, and the dancing. Adele can stand her ass right the fuck there in the black sequins. Ain't do, and then she ain't gotta move, she ain't gotta spin, she ain't gotta twirl, can just stand there and fucking sing and sell records. And unlike a lot of artists, she sounds, if not close to identical, the exact same live as she does on her records. So that is why Adele is selling. And Adele is smart. She uses her pain and everything to create good, genuine music. I mean, again, I don't know if I ever said this on here, but I'm gonna say Adele is a bad bitch. And I mean this in a good way. You know, she hit her last album, what was it? 21, 21, her last album. She's so smooth with it. That album was because of a breakup. Most of those songs came from a breakup. Do you know what she did? Do you know what she did? She wrote a check to her ex and pretty much just told him, thank you, because if it wasn't for you breaking my heart or whatnot, this album wouldn't have did what it did, wouldn't have sold what it did. I'm like, come on, bitch. Well, I mean, hey, Billboard said fuck it. I mean, but you know, it is what it is. So let's go ahead and move on to the juicy shit, because this has been trending and everybody done talked about it. Oh no, they cannot. They cannot. It's only a few. You know what I'm saying? Like that good stand there and sing, like that shit died in the early 2000s. Like, I mean, you got the best of live vocal performances in the 90s. It started to like fade out in 2000s. After we got past 2010, that shit dead. Period. So let's go ahead and talk about Kanye, Wiz Khalifa, and Amber Rose. And I think I have enough tea that's gonna get me through this. Hopefully my ass not lit. Okay, so let's go ahead and start now. We're gonna call this the Tabloid of Trending Topics with T Storyline. I'm not storyline, story time. See, I'm already drunk. And I'm just gonna go through these tweets. We're gonna stop. And what do you mean, hopefully, James? What does that mean? Anyway, I'm going to go through these tweets. We're going to talk and we're going to interact because I know y'all got some shit to say, as do I. I don't claim Kanye from the shot. Like I said, his Chi-Town car has been revoked, so So he starts off, and I'm gonna try to give this to you as in chronological order as I can. This is not album of the year. This is album of the life. Boom. New album titles, Waves. Hashtag Waves, the album formerly known as Swish. Now, it is at this point, actually, let me take that back, because these are what should have been said is when he said new album title Waves, Wiz Khalifa had tweeted, please don't take the wave. Then Kanye, I don't know if it was in a reply, but it's just like the sequence of how these tweets came out. Hashtag Waves, the album formerly known as Swish. And Wiz also tweeted, Max B is the wavy one. He created the wave. There is no wave without him. Ready for the real juice. Now, and moving on, someone had tweeted, don't even play yourself by stroking your own ego trying to claim the way. Max B is the only Corrado. I don't know what that is, but I'm just reading what's there. Wiz Khalifa retweeted with a quote saying, I'm a wavy baby for sure, and I'm not having it. And then Wiz also says, he's the reason I sing on all my songs. Now, I don't really listen to Wiz. Does Wiz sing, or does he auto-tune? Okay, no tea, no shade. I really want to know. I didn't. I'm still just trying to figure out, does Wiz Khalifa sing? Because if so, I want to know, like, what is his range? What is he? Is he a tenor? Let me not even do that. Wiz Khalifa raps. Okay. So, but he also says, that's the wave. If there's nothing with that sound, it's not wavy. Okay. He doesn't sing. The one song that I heard that it was so catchy, but I it was just one of those where I just couldn't do it, was Black and Yellow. Like, and now that I said it, now it's playing in my fucking head right now. We're not gonna talk about most male singers being, you know what, we're not gonna do that, because I know already, you know, I know James O'Hare, I was already on my soapbox talking about, you know, we're not gonna do this today, because y'all gonna have me sit here and go off on a smooth another fucking tangent, and I already went off in a couple of fucking scopes and blabs. I'm trying to be on my best behavior today, y'all. So, Kanye West tweets, all respect to Andrew Harrell and Max B hashtag waves. Wiz Khalifa actually there is a baritone in pop music. There is a baritone. It's a British group. I forget the group name and I forget the young male, but there is a male singer who is a baritone. And I know this because Meghan Trainor has that song with John Legend. And when she was on tour, she actually had this gentleman get on stage to do John Legend's part. So we do have a baritone that is in pop music. Just not really, you know, I know it's about the baritones, y'all. Okay, back to the story. So, I know. So Wiz pretty much says, yeah, right. And then Wiz goes on to say, Max B, number one trending, free the way. moving on. Now, that was it. They were done. They left that. Now, I don't follow Wiz, but damn it, I know Wiz likes to do one thing. He likes to motherfucking smoke weed. I'm pretty sure Wiz likes to smoke weed more than he likes to fuck. I'm pretty sure he likes smoke weed more than he likes to motherfucking eat. Okay. Everything he do is weed. Marijuana. Okay. That's what he likes to do. It's too good in a motherfucker. Okay. So, here's where the shit really pops off. Okay, here we go. So, this is on the 27th, okay? Ain't shit wrong with that, baby. Ain't shit wrong with that shit. I'm in a different motherfucking galaxy, okay? Physically, my body's just present here. But shit, everything me is in a different motherfucking galaxy. Okay. So, he says, hit this KK and become yourself. Now, it was at some point that Kanye said something. I don't have the exact tweet that he said, like that he went off and said something. Which I say how like that. But Wiz comes back and says, KK is weed fool. Reasons why you're not wavy. Go back to Swish. Now, here's the thing. I'm pretty sure, like, Kanye thought that KK meant his wife. So apparently he did a little bit of going in. Wiz's whole thing is, bruh, KK means weed, man. California Kush, man. And left it at that. But y'all know Kanye. Kanye got them bitch-ass tendencies. So now Kanye goes and he starts writing a book on our ass. So I'm finna just start reading what he said. Now, I hope y'all ready. I hope y'all got y'all cups, okay? Cause y'all cup finna run over. I hope y'all got a backup cup to the cup, cause we about to talk about some shit. Here we go. So, oh, niggas must think I'm not petty, cause I'm the best that's ever made music. Are you ready? You okay? Y'all better get ready. Here we go. Like, oh, that's ye, and I can put his wife's initials on my Twitter, so he's in his feelings. Bro, first of all, you stole your whole shit from Cuddy. Now, here we go. Shots being fired.
Punched up at me.
Second, your first single was corny as fuck and most thereafter. Good morning. Okay, good morning, Southside. Hey. You have distracted from my creative process. I went to look at your Twitter and you were wearing cool pants. I screen grabbed those pants and sent it to my style team. Now, I'm a pause work. Oh, he's very bipolar. I'm a pause there. So you went to his Twitter. So you stalking his Twitter. So you're a grown ass man stalking another man's Twitter. Okay. Third, no one I know has ever listened to one of your albums all the way through. Again, shots being fired, y'all. Now, here's, let me take a sip. I need for this next one. Okay. Fourth, you let a stripper trap you. Now we all know who he talking about now. Y'all know how Kanye whole thing is, if it ain't Kanye, it ain't shit. That's Kanye. Kanye feel like ain't nobody did it better than he done did it. Oh, he not done. Kanye not done. Oh, he's very arrogant. But he not done, because here we go. Fifth, I know you mad every time you look at your child that this girl got you for 18 years. Now, first and foremost, the whole 18 years thing, y'all remember his song Gold Digger? 18 years. 18 years. You got one of her kids got you for 18 years. That's that right there. Oh, yeah. This is where he fucked. But here's the thing. That's not exactly where he fucked up, but that's when he opened the door for what's about to come a little bit later. And the whole thing is, he said, now, all I'm gonna say is this, in general, y'all take this however y'all want to take it, and wherever y'all want to take it, because y'all already know, if y'all have been rocking with me for a minute, y'all know that I have no chill. Y'all know that I have no chill. But this right here is going to be a prime example of bringing up somebody's child. You leave children out of every fucking thing. I said last week when I was talking about... I know. Because he mentioned Amber indirectly, but mentioned her. But he mentioned the child more than this one time. But you don't bring children into fucking mess. If y'all watch my Real Housewives of Potomac review, I understand. Like, I know some people just like they were okay with Giselle bringing her kids. Oh yeah, you never when we play dirty, never. I'm not here for Lanithia, but I'll give her that. But I wasn't here for her bringing her children into adult situations with the whole Farrah and Nicki Minaj from last week. I did not think that it was cool for Farrah to have her daughter go on, I think it was IG or even Twitter, posting a picture you leave kids out of grown folks shit. You don't involve kids physically, but you don't talk about kids. Kids ain't got nothing to do with shit. And I'm going to talk more about that in reference to Kanye, but let's get back to the story time. Because Kanye got in his feelings, so here we go. 6, don't ever come out the side of your neck at me. 7, I am your OG, and I will be respected as such. 8, I made it so we could wear tight jeans. I'm going to have to ask you to not be proud of that, Kanye. Yeah. 9, me and Cuddy created this shit. Now, if we're going to use proper grammar, it should have been Cuddy and I, but, you know, it's Kanye, so he probably rewrote grammar. Oh, yeah, well, here's the thing. Shit, he let his ego get the best of him, but somebody popped that shit. Yeah, and I'm going to read all the way up to it. And the fucked up thing is, I'm pretty sure they had numbers. He could have just called the motherfucker, but it is what it is. Again, if y'all haven't shit, I know he did. I need to take another sip, because this shit getting too good. Continuing on. I know, say no to tight jeans, Bible. 10, don't you ever in your fucking life speak sideways about a nigga that's fighting for us. I do this for all of us. 11th, I showed you respect as a man when I met you. 12, you would, now here we go. Here's where shit started to really go left. Okay. Because this is when Amber was about ready to tag herself in. 12, you wouldn't have a child if it wasn't for me. I know, what did he do for all of us? But again, 12th, you wouldn't have a child if it wasn't for me. Pretty much saying that. But the fact that he said that is one of those ways, it's like, last that I checked, Amber broke it off with you. But he's pretty much saying, had it not been for me and had we not broken up, the child that you currently have with her. Oh, he did, but he just added to the fuck shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm just like, bruh. But it gets better, unfortunately. Now here is where he truly fucked up, y'all. 13th, you own waves with 4 question marks. I own your child with 4 exclamation points. This is 13 out of 17. I'm gonna give y'all a minute, because I know some of y'all, I'm gonna give y'all a minute before we finish with this story time. Bray J won't die. Oh, he did, because the thing is, after Wiz posted his 2 tweets, and then his ass went back to planet the Wiz. Like, this motherfucker went back on the planet and just kept on getting high, and just like, oh, well. Literally paid this shit complete fucking dust. Okay, and I'm just like, how dare you say, you own waves, I own your child. You did, but I mean, we're in the midst of the big shit, sis. We're in the midst of the big shit. So, I'm reading the Chronicles that is Kanye West Holern. yes, Planet the Wiz. Yes, he did his 2 tweets, hit that blunt, went back to Planet the Wiz. I said this shit. Yeah, I said, with a straight face. Yeah, But I meant, of the Chronicles of Kanye, out of the 17, we're at number 13, where he says, you own ways with 4 question marks. I own your child with 4 exclamation points or marks. Now, if he hadn't fucked up before, this is where he truly fucked up. Because you done brought in the mama, you done talked about the child 2 times before, and now you saying you own the child. Oh, he was unbothered, but Mama Bear wasn't. Mama Bear was ready for that ass. We finna talk about it. We hold on. Oh, you want her to get ultra padded? She can't show that you got ultra padded. So let's go ahead and finish. I know we having a good time with, I know, and again, y'all, like I said, I'm sorry. I forgot to post last week's trending topics. This motherfucker gonna be up. Now, this one will be up. Okay, I promise y'all that. Moving on, number 14. 14th. Nigga, it's called creativity. Hashtag, you should try it someday. Child. I don't want her to do it. You know, Superhead and already did and fucked it up for everybody. We gonna talk more in depth about this, but I'm just trying to get through the chronicles because I'm gonna have to change glasses in a minute. I'm about to put my reading glasses on. 15th, nigga, I tried to call you and you changed your number. Now, I did mention that they could have talked this over. My thing is this, if you really want to get in contact with him, you could have. I think that there was you feel what I'm saying? Damn, so I said so. Come on now. But I think that he could have reached out to him if he wanted to. This shit did not. I told y'all they gonna make their debut, and I think they finna make their debut today. 16. Don't even hint at mention. Okay, hold on. Mm-mm. Okay. Here we go, y'all. Don't even hint at mentioning me or my family or my wife. I am your OG now. Hold on. Yes, I can see you, James. Live in living color, yes. Now, this simple-minded motherfucker here, you gonna sit here and say, hold on. Don't even hint at mentioning me, my family, or my wife, right? Scrolling back. But you done mentioned his baby mama with the 4th. You let a stripper trap you. Okay. With the 5th says, you know, got you for 18 years. Okay. Hold on. Da 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 da. If it was number 12, if it wasn't for me, if it. You wouldn't have a child if it wasn't for me. 13, you own waves. I own your child. And now you want to sit here and say, don't even hint. Don't even hint at mentioning my family, my wife, or me. Really? So it's one of the things, because we all know that Kanye has this God complex about himself. So you can sit here and talk all this shit about old boy, his baby mama, and his child. But he been not hinting saying shit about you. We not done. We not done because we finna talk. We finna talk today. I know. See, fuck it. I got the shit here. You want to sit here and say you let a stripper trap you? My whole thing is this. Amber Rose is more respectable than Kim Kardashian any fucking day. Because last that I checked, I think there was a small group of people that had the pleasure of even seeing her clitoris. But we didn't see Kim's tits,
her clitoris, that fake ass, and everything else when Ray J was pile driving the fuck out of her. We didn't saw all her motherfucking goods, because see, what you got was fucking used and abused, okay? Hashtag reused. That's what the fuck your ass got, Kanye. So here's the thing. He let a stripper trap him. Well, guess what? You let a porn star trap you. That's what the fuck you done did, okay? Bitch ass mother, babe. I mean, here's the thing. If Kanye really wanted to do it, what he should have did is he should have got with Kris Jenner. Okay? And that's who he should have got over with Kris. He should have got Kris ass. But we not done. We not done. Y'all just get ready, because like I said, we family here. You know what? Oh, some real shit. We should have took this shit to Blab, but fuck it. We here. I said, I'm going to keep doing the trending topics on Periscope. We should have took this shit to Blab, though. Hindsight being 2020. Oh, yeah, that battle coochie. Yes. The cougar puss. Yes. That wow. Yes. Purring on that ass. Yes. I'm just saying, you know what I'm saying? Like, Kanye need to step his motherfucking pussy, okay? Shit. Because my whole thing is this, because all you got was some old manufactured shit, okay? The real motherfucking moneymaker is Kris. She the one pimping these hoes out, and last that I checked, she pimping his ass out too, okay? So I'm just trying to figure out what the fuck Kanye ass talking. We not done. We definitely not done. And hold on. Can't go back. Oh yes. Kris is the real. Yes. The real OG. She is the madame. Yes. I'm just saying, cause here's the. It's two people pimping Kanye, and that's Jay-Z and motherfucking Kris. And sometimes they be fighting to figure out who. You know. Let me stop. I'm going too far. I'm going too far. 17. I think you dress cool. Wish I was skinny and tall. Maybe I couldn't be skinny and tall, but I'll settle for being the greatest artist of all time as a constellation. Don't ever come out of side of your neck. Come out of side of your motherfucking neck, bro. Or bruh, or whatever you say it, Mr. Waves. I'm ye. I ain't gonna say it right. I'm not gonna say it the right way. I'm ye. He says it a couple more fucking times, whatever. Thank you for the extra promotion. Hashtag waves available February 11th. Now, we gonna take a small intermission. And I say it's a small intermission because he did. Maybe it was Yeezus. I don't know. Somebody did. It wasn't me. Fuckers, come on, sis. Come on, baby. Oh, yes. Well, see, here's the thing. Because Mama Bear, a.k.a. Mother Goose, is about to slide her ass right the fuck on in. And I'm about to be here for every motherfucking moment, okay? Here's the thing. Y'all type away, because we on an intermission. Because I got some tea that I need to drink. Well, I mean, here's the thing. Ray J is still making money off this damn motherfucking sex tape, okay? That's all I'm going to say. He's still making motherfucking money. If Ray J ain't got to do shit, okay? He's still making motherfucking money off this pussy. Her pussy. Kanye's new motherfucking pussy. Married motherfucking pussy. But before we get into what... before we get into Amber... I do want to say this. we gonna talk about why he deleted the tweets. Oh, we gonna talk about it because it's story time, y'all. It's story time. So here's the thing. Kanye wants to sit here and quote his song Gold Digger, which is a great song. I'm not gonna lie, I really do enjoy that song. It's a great fucking song. It's just so funny how got that all the way to fuck together, baby. But I find it to be so funny that you want to sit here and try to throw this at him. But let's look at Gold Digger and look at you. He said 18 years, got one of your kids, got you for 18 years. Now, how many kids do you have back here? I'm not checking for them, but I think it's two. If it's more than that, let me know. But two. Now, I hope he has a prenuptial agreement. Because if he does not, Kim can easily be like, you know what? I'm done. On to the next, dick. On to the next. And she gonna get some alimony. She gonna get that child support. Yes, she gonna get all of it, baby. And the fact that you have two children by her, it outweighs that one child that Wiz Khalifa has with Amber Rose, which means who got who for 18 years? Who got who? Let's be real about this. It's one of those where you want to come for him. Come on now. And here's my whole thing. He better be on his Johnny Taylor tip. It's cheaper to keep her. Oh, it's cheaper to keep her. He need to be on that motherfucking tip. Because if he ain't got a prenuptial, he better stay on it, okay? Oh, yes. She gonna take her thing. Come on, sit cheaper to keep her. Yes, Johnny Taylor. Y'all know, okay, tangent. Y'all know I love me some old school. Y'all know I do. Y'all got the realest shit with old school music. Johnny Taylor told y'all asses it's cheaper to keep her. He told y'all asses about them last $2. Okay, don't bring him into this foolishness. I'm just saying, you know, shit, we learned about Jody when Jody's got your girl and gone, okay? I'm gonna keep it cute today. I'm just saying, we know about that old school. You shit, if y'all follow me on last $2, I'm not gonna lose. Y'all not. Let me stop, cause I'm about to. I'm about to channel my inner motherfucking old spirit up in this bitch. But what I'm saying is, I'm mute. That's all that I'm saying. And for those of y'all who are youngs that don't know about Johnny Taylor, that don't know about It's Cheaper to Keep Her, when we get done here, go to YouTube, type in Johnny Taylor, Cheaper to Keep Her. Also check out them last $2. Also check out Jody. She's got your girl and gone. It's going to bless y'all on this Sunday afternoon. I was going to say morning, but it's not morning no more. This Sunday afternoon. But that's all that I'm saying. So it's one, and then the whole... And Kanye even said the best, and when he get on, leave your ass for a white girl. Fuck your ass, dude. Okay. So I'm done giving y'all the oldest lesson. Better yet, James, since you own here, if you will be ever so kind, why don't you do a sound spill on Mr. Johnny Taylor? Cause you know they ain't ready. They don't know about Johnny. Shit, here's the thing, y'all. I can give y'all some motherfucking songs, okay? I can give y'all some songs that's gonna have y'all ass just like, oh Lord, I wasn't ready, okay? Like I said, y'all know I love me some Bobby Womack, okay? If you think you're lonely now, wait until y'all not finna have me on here doing it. y'all not gonna have me on here doing this now. Not today. Back to the story. So that was our little intermission. Now we're getting back to the story. So, Mama Bear been sitting on the sideline this whole time, watching the fuck shit and the foolery unfold. Oh, yes. So, now here's the thing. is everybody. Amber Rose, contrary to what y'all think, she literally killed his ass with one tweet. She came back and blessed us with a second. She killed his ass with a two-piece without a motherfucking biscuit, baby. Okay. You know what? I don't even think it was a tag. I think she just walked up, muffed the fuck out of Wiz, like, bitch, get the fuck out of my way. Let me show you how the fuck you clap back. Let me show you rights quick. So here's what Amber had to say. Oh, she did it. She did it. She says, aw. And then she added his ass at Kanye West. Are you mad? I'm not playing. I'm sorry, I'm not around to play in your asshole anymore. Hashtag fingers in the booty ass bitch. I died. Now we gonna talk more about this, but I died. His dad did his arm, yeah. Woo! One tweet, baby. With one tweet. Got his ass, pun intended, smooth the fuck together. Got that ass to get. I'm gonna read it one more time because it was so good. I'm gonna read it one more time, y'all. Aw at Kanye West. Are you mad I'm not playing around in your asshole anymore? One hit quitter. Come on, boo. Fingers in the ass. I'm sorry, finger in the booty ass, bitch. Got his ass together. Quick, fast, in a motherfucking hurry. Dude, you know what, y'all? Black Twitter ain't got no chill. None of the, I seen them damn pictures. I hollered. I fucking hollered. I was done. I was through. Oh, I had to read it. I had to. Because it was one of those where it was just like, you know what? Let me go ahead and let me bury your ass right quick. With one tweet. Now, with that one tweet, y'all. He says, I'm going to take these down because it's all about positive energy, blessings, positive energy, blessings. So Mama Bear comes in, Mother Goose comes in with one fucking tweet. God, I didn't see them all, y'all. Comes in with one tweet. Now you want to sit here and take down every last fucking comment that your ass and motherfucking put up. Every last one. Because Mama Bear came in. And because here's the thing. That was a knockout punch. Now, Amber, like, yes, baby, like a wrecking ball. Yes. Yes. Now, Amber could have let it go because she here's the thing. She buried him, but she wasn't done. She was not done. Amber went, dug up the grave, pulled his ass back up because he was still breathing. And yes, bodied him. I'm about to say it. Laugh out loud at Kanye West. Now you want to delete your tweets because mother has arrived. Hashtag Twitter fingers. Hashtag you're getting bodied by a stripper, nigga. Done. So pretty much she dug his ass up, mother. Yes, dug his ass out the motherfucking grave. Bodied his ass and then put him back in the grave. Served him up a motherfucking two-piece without the fucking biscuit. He wasn't worthy of the motherfucking biscuit. He wasn't worthy of a fucking combo meal. He ain't get no fries on the side. He ain't get a medium motherfucking drink. He ain't get no motherfucking refills on the motherfucking drink. All his ass got was a motherfucking two-piece. Come on through. Come on, Amber. Come on through, bitch. Come on through with the two-piece, baby. Hey, he did it, but it was one, but again, well, here, you know what, he can't stand in it because he still, you know, got Amber finger up his ass, maybe Kim's. Now, because we're almost done, and then we're going to just talk, because I do have something that I do want to say about Amber, about this whole entire thing. Like, I know I came on late, but hopefully I'm giving y'all lives with this shit. I'm hoping y'all enjoying this. Okay. Now, Kanye has a series of tweets that goes something like this. I'm happy that I now know that KK means we. Please excuse the confusion. Back to hashtag waves. Are y'all getting it? Okay, okay. All right. You know what? I don't check for Wendell, so I don't know what the fuck Wendell done said. Because I don't check for that, you know, manly, beastly looking ass bitch. Okay, I'm just trying to figure out how the fuck your ass got titties and all this weave, and you look more manly than me. You know, how, unless I let my voice drop, bitch, you got more bass in your motherfucking voice than me. Okay, how your Adam's apple protrude more than my, you know what, you see, why y'all doing that? Y'all know I'm trying to behave today. Stop that. He also says, bad surgeries. Man, it's a sad day. Wiz lost 2 million followers since I tweeted. Didn't mean to either him like that. I get, I don't know. Ugly drag queen. I mean, she's a bad bodybuild bitch. Shit, that's all. Yeah, on flash shit, she can't throw that shit in the circle. Gotta throw it in the square. That's all she gotta do. I'm trying to behave, okay? I've had my moments where I done went the fuck off on camera. I'm trying to turn over a new leaf. I'm trying to behave. And then he ends by saying, I'm in the lab with Ian Connor, by the way. Don't know who that is, but we're name dropping. Now, when it was all said and done, after Amber Rose buried, resurrected, and rebodied, then buried his ass yet again. Here's what Kanye had to say when it was all said and done. God's dream. Now you're going to bring the Lord into this. Should have been thinking about the Lord before you had them damn Twitter fingers. But on the Lord's day, a day that the Lord done made. God's dream, .. Never speak on kids again, .. All love, .. All blessings, .. Now, before we get into the very end of this, let me say this. Again, for all of those who hear me talk right now, who can hear what I am saying, this right here is a prime example of when you talk about somebody's children. You know, I think Amber has more than she can actually tell. She's choosing not to. She's trying to keep it cute. But let me say this, and I'm going to borrow something that my sister says, because she's on here, so I think I can borrow it. When you talk about a woman's eggs, you open up. Hey, how you doing? You open yourself up for some shit, okay? You know, it says hell have no fury like a woman scorned. Bump that. Hell, heaven, and everything that creepeth has no fury when you fuck with a woman's children. When you bring up a woman's child. Okay. Okay, you don't do that. You don't do that. And here's the thing. Men are even sensitive about their damn children. I don't have kids. I have nieces and nephews. I almost whooped the motherfucker's ass when I was in grade school. Because, you know, my older brother is older than me significantly. A motherfucker says shit about my motherfucking niece. His ass almost got his ass handed to him in the motherfucking cafeteria. My nieces and my nephew, they are like my damn kids because I don't have any. You not finna fucking talk about them, because if you do, you have five. Okay, well bless you, baby. Bless you. You talk about any of them, we have a fucking issue. Okay? I'm not going to talk too much about it, but somebody that's close in the circle of family snatched up my niece at a motherfucking funeral, and I went from mourning to about ready to sit here and put my hands on a motherfucking female. We don't do these things. So, when you bring children into shit, when you bring somebody's eggs into shit, you don't expect that ain't shit gonna happen. And then for Kanye, the little bitch ass, cowardly ass motherfucking nigga that he is, I would say he was in his light skin feelings. Yeah, I'll fucking say, because he ain't light skin before, he was in his motherfucking light skin feelings. You say all this shit. I will kick some ass over my nieces and my nephew too. Come on through. come on through. But you done said all this shit, and then before you concluded, you say, don't hint at my wife, my family, or me, but you done already brought in his baby mama. You done said you wouldn't have your child if it wasn't for me. I own your child. And you really thought Mama Bear wasn't finna come in and sit here and snatch the little bit of hair that was on your head? You didn't think that she was gonna sit here and bury your motherfucking ass? You didn't think that she was gonna sit here and resurrect your ass and then body you and then put you back in the grave and put the dirt back over your ass? You didn't think that shit wasn't gonna happen? And the reality is, last that I checked, y'all correct me if I'm wrong, Amber Rose left you. Amber Rose was done with you. And you hurt. You probably hurt because Amber Rose was what you wanted, but you wasn't what she needed, and her ass went and moved on to the fucking next. You the one that still pressed about her. You the one that constantly got her motherfucking name in your mouth, because she ain't talking about you, she ain't stunting you, she ain't sweating you, but you fucking talking about her. And Amber Rose was keeping it cute, but when you brought her up, indirectly saying you let a stripper trap you, and then you brought the motherfucking kids up. I want everybody on here to fucking understand and catch the shade that I'm fucking throwing. And at the same exact time, if any of y'all want to be messy, by all means, please do. Because if y'all haven't noticed, Yarell has no motherfucking chill. And I will fucking go there. I will. I know I have a brand to protect, but at the same exact time, ain't shit fake about this motherfucker over here, and you not finna come for me. Even though I don't like Karen of the Real Housewives of Potomac, motherfuckers come for me all the time. They just can't find me. But try me if you want to. But you don't talk about somebody's fucking eggs. You don't. And at the same exact time, with all this shit going on, I get wrong fucking tea, y'all. I get wrong. Not get ring. Get wrong fucking tea, y'all. Had Wiz. First of all, Wiz was high off his fucking mind. He typed that last tweet about, you dumb, KK means this, and was done. I get wrong tea, y'all. Had Wiz came back and said some shit about Kim Kardashian, overinflated motherfucking helium booted bitch, built bitch ass motherfucking, had he talked about her, he would have been in his feelings. But had he brought up his motherfucking kids, talking, had he brought up his motherfucking north, east, south, and motherfucking west ass motherfucking kids, he would have been in his motherfucking feelings. He would have been in it. So the fact, yes, helium fucking inflated. Yes, I fucking said it. I did. Y'all know I did. I told y'all I'd put the, this, y'all done got the fucking debut of the motherfucking reading glasses. Debut. I told y'all I was gonna do it at some point. Motherfucker, we here right now. We fucking here right now. But Wiz ain't say shit about your kid. Better yet. Better fucking yet. Amber could have came for your motherfucking kids. She could have went in and let have on your kids, but she didn't. She kept it cute, but what she did do is talked about you locking fingers in a whole booty-ass motherfucking-ass nigga, and it wasn't for a motherfucking prostate exam either. I got a little bit more. I got a little bit more. I'm going to pause for a minute. I'm going to let my blood pressure come back down. You gay? No, I'm not. So, yeah. There you go. So I'm gonna let my blood pressure come back down. I'm gonna let y'all type right quick. And I'm gonna read and I'm gonna hit my favorite. Yeah. Come on, Zen. I got you, sis. I got you, baby. But how the tea almost. Do y'all not see what I was talking about? Did y'all not see what? Now, here's the thing. For those of y'all who don't know me, who don't follow me, right? Yeah, he paid for attention. I keeps Long Island on deck. I have my Long Island's pre-mix. Okay, I did a in the kitchen about how I make my Long Island's. So I have Long Island's for days. I can make another one on camera if I needed to. But I think this is good. I think this is good. Yeah, yeah, we cutting up. We cutting up. I'm going to try to not put these glasses on. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to try to keep them on the side. Yeah, you right. You right. Mm-hmm. But again, had somebody, and when I say somebody, I mean had Wiz. said anything about this man's kids, he would have been in his damn feelings. Had Amber brought up the kids, he would have been in his damn feelings. But the fact that she killed you with one tweet, I'm not going to talk about Rob and Black China. I'm not going to do that. What? Wait. What you mean? Don't wait. Hold on. If you want to know how I make the drink. Oh, well, thank you so much for following. Okay, you a tea spiller, baby. If you want to know how I make my Long Island again, just go over to my YouTube channel, Spilling All the Tea. And if you find it in the kitchens, I show you how I make it. So I'm definitely sharing. Okay. And that's one thing. Like, even though I'm about to talk about Amber, because I'm upset about one thing, but I will say when she went in on him. You're a new follower. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. I'm glad you enjoy me cutting the fucking food today. I don't cut the food every Sunday, but damn it, we cutting the food today. They gave me some shit to fucking run with, so we gonna run with it, okay? But she did not bring his kids up at all. But she buried that ass. She bodied that ass. Okay. She pretty much, what she did is, because y'all know Phaedra Parks got all these jobs, and apparently, you know, she does funerals and shit. But apparently she took Phaedra's job for one day and buried some motherfucking body. Fuck them all. So, I have one more thing to read, and then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to talk about Amber. Yes, Amber won. Hands down. There was one thing that happened that I am upset about, and I'm going to talk about it momentarily. Amber won. Here's the thing, y'all. Again, y'all need to understand. When you bring somebody's kids into some shit, you need to be ready. Where my chat? Okay, hold on. I've been licking on these lips. Hold on. Y'all know chap lips ain't sexy. I would never be on here with chap lips. Y'all know how I do. Chap, stuck that motherfucking finger up. With one mother, yes, with one tweet. She didn't even have to read. She didn't even have to do the second fucking tweet. Because she did the first one. Now you was hit her thing down. Okay, hit that motherfucker with the Teddy Pendergrass. Just another love TKO on that ass. Laid his ass out. Shit, I had to pick up his motherfucking face, self-respect, and everything else. Mm-hmm, yeah. Yeah, that's right, Nika. Yes, baby. So let's go ahead and finish the story time. And then I'll talk about Amber right quick. Scabashes. Okay. So in a podcast, this is what Amber had to say. I would never talk about kids in an argument, which she didn't. It just shows the type of person he is. Even him saying stuff about my son, I still didn't say anything about his kids. I'm not going to. This is ridiculous. They're innocent babies. You don't ever, ever talk about a baby, ever. That just shows how fucking ridiculous he is. Now, she was asked, was she surprised about Kanye? She says, no, because I know him. I know he's a fucking clown. The crazy thing is he came out with a song last week saying that I had my son for a meal ticket. I didn't even say anything. I was just like, man, he's a cornball. I'm not saying shit. Then he's on the internet like a stripper trap you. Exactly right, Amber. Wiz, but like you took me around the world. We dated for 2 years, but you're talking shit about Wiz and my baby? Question mark. He still talks about me in songs. He still talks about me all day. My question is, so who is your muse, Kanye? Is your muse Amber or is it Kim? Now, before I finish off my drink and before I give my closing remarks on all of this. Really? Okay, you know what? Now I gotta go see what Wendell then said. Oh, hey, boo. Hey, how you doing? You know what? I honestly think that he found his soulmate in Amber. And it must have broke him. I can't stand both any of that. But I think it broke him when she decided we're done. Yeah, what is... if y'all don't watch me... Look now. Pause, tangent. I have names for everybody, okay? If y'all watch The Households of Atlanta, Portia Williams is Horsha for a good reason. Phaedra Parks is Fake-dra. I have names. When we talk about music, Tyrese Gibson is Teresa. I have names for people, okay? I have names. And Wendy Williams is a fucking Wendell, okay? Peter Thomas is Patricia. Okay, I got names from motherfucking days and shit. Okay, cause you mean I'm not mean. I am not mean, and I think I'm done with these glasses. I think I'm done. I'm gonna put those away. I'm gonna put my regular glasses back on. All right. So, so here is the only thing that I really have to say about Amber. I was completely here for her burying the fuck out of Kanye. Wardrobe change. Y'all not ready. Okay, you know what? You guys do me a favor. Take your glass off. Do me a favor. My name on Twitter is T Spilling. T-E-A and Spilling. So T Spilling. We want to see. If I take my glasses off, then you know I cannot read the comments, James. Okay? And I think that's rude for y'all to comment. I can't read it. That is rude. I don't want to be rude. Okay? I cannot read comments. I'll take them off for just a second. Okay? Since James wanted me to take my damn glasses off. So you guys get it. So please don't type. Please don't type because I won't be able to read it. Okay? So here's what I'm going to say about Amber. Now, when I put my glasses back on, then type whatever you guys want, okay? So, the only thing that upsets me with what Amber did is, I'm not going to say she exposed Kanye because everybody have been saying for the longest that he's bi. And again, if y'all know me, I'm all about just living your life, doing you. I'm all about being an individual. I hate labels. I hate titles. I hate putting people in boxes. So, whatever Kanye decides to do is what Kanye decides to do. I really don't fucking care. I really don't. But what I will say is, Amber, you are the same one that you don't want anybody to talk about you. Talk about the whole, you being a stripper. You know, the whole, I think it's the slut walk. You don't want anybody to talk about that. You don't want anybody to come at you with and about that. So the fact that you go against Kanye and you talk about you putting your finger in his asshole, is that not on the same fucking level? You feel what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to say that she outed him, but it's just like, is that not on the same fucking level? And then it even goes to the same thing with, you know, us having friends and whatnot. Like, I'm friends with, like, I have had friendships that have went south. And with what I do for a living, I have, like, with the last friendship that went left, I could have easily said some shit and broke this female's whole fucking foundation because you came for me and you fuck with me and mine. I could have fucked up your whole foundation, but I kept it cute and I didn't. So it's one of those where I think that that is information that she should have kept to herself, especially because, okay, you know what? I put the glass button because y'all typing and shit. Hold on. Yeah. And all that I'm getting at is just like, you don't want anybody to come at you left because you were a stripper. So why would you bring up something about you putting your fingers in Kanye's ass? It's one of those where it's just like, we all grown. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not finna sit here and expose her like that. I'm not gonna say I never talked about it. Because there were certain instances where the shit came up to where I had to clear the air. But I never exposed her, especially when we were in this, like, we both were in Korea. I could have exposed her and fucked all, because she literally, because here's the thing, with the shit that she said about me, she fucked my career up and she fucked my fucking, my Joe's business up. She fucked our careers to the point where for me, I could have, I was able to rebound, almost couldn't. And I could have sat here and been like, well, since we want to sit here and reveal shit that we said in private to each other, what about this? But I chose not to do that. And that's kind of how I feel about, you know, Amber. Just that information, you could have kept that shit on the low low. But at the same exact time, you know, all is fair in love and war from what's being said. But the fact that he brought her kids into it, I'm not giving her a pass because I still think that she should have never said that. But at the same exact time, this is what happens when you bring somebody kids into this shit. Wait, who's a cool dude? What did I miss? I had my glass off. What did I miss, James? What did I miss? Now, when you say she, okay, y'all know I have my glasses off, so when you say she was mad, who was mad? If we're talking about Amber, she was mad, but for anybody that has kids, you know, oh, peanut head. Like, if for anybody that, Kenyatta, can I use Kenyatta? Can I use that? And what is it, Katie Swank? Can I use Kenyatta? I gotta ask permission, because I don't like using people's shit, you know, I don't want to get in trouble. Thank you, Kenyatta. But again, you brought her into a situation that had nothing to do with her. You did not mention the child. You did not allude to the child once. You alluded to the child three times. And again, what happened? Mama Bear, Mother Goose came in. It's Kenyatta. And here's what y'all need to understand about, like I said, bears. First and foremost, like, if you think about animals, mothers are the most protective of their young because they bear them. What people fail to realize about Goose, because like I said, you know, my Native American zodiac is a goose, but because I'm a male, it's a gander. We are protective of what is close to us, and I'm protective of my nieces and my nephews, so that's why I am the way that I am. But if you get too close to a goose, a gander, and their flock, what's gonna happen is you finna sit here, you finna see a bird attack your ass. You finna see them come at you because you didn't got too fucking close for comfort, which is what happened here. You don't play with the children because, again, regardless of what children say or do, they're innocent. Yeah, yeah. And she even said that he had made a song and everything else, but she chose to keep it cute. She chose to keep it cute, but it got to a point where she was like, you know what? Let me go ahead and insert myself just this one good time. Let me kill this situation one good time. So it is what it is. The only thing that I will say is just with everything that Amber Rose wants, with the whole slut walk and everything else, just keep that in mind, especially with what's going on between her and Kanye. It's kind of keep that in mind. That's all that I'm saying. But she was not wrong for what it is that she did. Now, had he not brought the kids up and, yeah, like, had he not brought the kids up and it just been he brought her up and she brought in the whole finger in the ass thing, then I really would have been like, okay, Kim, I'm not Kim, Amber, you went too far. Cause it had, but the fact that he brought the children up that had nothing to do, and then at the same exact time, you are the same one that's saying, don't bring me, my family, or my wife into this. Motherfucker, you done already did it. Oh, contradicting, but yeah, contradicting. So, before we sign off, because all that I have left, oh no, I got rid of my notes. No. Hold on. I kind of got rid of my notes a little too early, because I only had like, yeah, I just got two things to talk about, and then at this point, we're done, you guys. At this point, we are done. We're done. So, before I close this out, what y'all gotta say? Go ahead and type it in. And for those of you who do not know, I do transcribe this on YouTube. So the comments, when people watch this back on YouTube, they get to see the comments and everything else, you know. Hold your hands up for the people. Okay. Hands. I don't know what that meant, but okay. Hands. You have to write. Okay. Rewatch this. Okay. Now, my question is this, because, you know, I do have to ask. Maybe this is the Capricorn in me. Were you guys entertained? Did you guys enjoy this? Did you guys like the debut of the reading glasses? Like, let me know. I really want to know. Loved it? Just let, because I really want to know if you guys really enjoy this and all that good jazz. Yes, sure. In reference to us getting on Blab, at some point we will get on Blab. At a minimum, the panel will get on Blab once a month. But at the same exact time, it was nice. Thank you. We only want to give you guys substance. We only want to give substance. We don't want to just come on camera. You enjoy this every Sunday. Thank you so much. Thank you. You was here for the reading glasses? Okay. Oh, it's a Yarelism? Whatever, James. Whatever. But what we like to do, the panel as a whole, we don't want to, like, even though we end up shooting the shit in, at the very end, we like to come with substance. So what I ask you guys to do is, whether it be, because I said, myself and Squeaky Jones, we, I guess you could say we are, I guess, the creators of just the whole idea of us coming together. Hit one of us up. I didn't say Brown Beauty. Well, y'all know I love Brown Beauty, baby. I mean, like, do y'all not see this right here? Y'all see this? Shit. But if you guys have any topics or any huge topics that you would like us to talk about, if you so feel, you guys can... You know, everybody has their little things when they get to reading people, you know what I'm saying? Like Justin J, he has his black V-neck. My sister, Lady Nika, she does the black screen reads. Mine will be the reading glasses. And even then, you're only going to see the reading glasses every so often. Y'all might get a surprise to see me wearing some shades every now and then, but, you know, it is what it is. But, if you guys have any topics that you would like for us to talk about, by all means, please email me at a minimum. Like I said, my email address is in the bottom of every video. SpillingAllTea@gmail.com. Oh, that Christmas blab was the shit. That Christmas blab was the shit, okay? Actually, if you guys have not seen the latest blab that we did, Alexander Rogers, he... uploaded the last blab. So if you guys go to his channel, Alexander Rogers, he uploaded the last one. And even though I've said this, I do want everyone just to kind of generally understand with the panel. The panel is a set group of people. It is what it is. It's a set group of people. And what we try to do is one person on the panel, we try to sit on the panel or the list of four, and we have three other people there. And the whole purpose for that one person from the panel being there is just to make sure that nothing goes too far left or too far right. And what we try to do is we try to pick somebody, whether they be in the panel or not in the panel, to upload the video, because everybody has a different set of followers. And it gives everybody that chance to, you know, eat a little bit, you know, because we all do different things. And even though we all sort of kind of do the same exact things, we have this many subscribers amongst each other, but we're trying to sit here and merge everything. And even with Alex uploading the last video, I've gained subscribers because of that, and I would like to think that everybody else that was on that particular blab did. So that's really all that it's about. It's not about you, because I know some people didn't talk and said T Spilling is just trying to promote himself over everybody else. Not the case. It's all about everybody coming together, because we all can eat. So if you guys have any questions or any topics you would like us to discuss, let us know. I was thinking about doing one. Oh, I love Alex too. Y'all know I do. You know, okay, you know what? You know what, sis? You can do the next one. You can actually do the next one on some real shit. But, oh, you subscribe to him because of the blab? I thought you would have been subscribed to him before that. But what I will say is this. I do want to do a health and wellness blab, because y'all know that's what I'm doing. But in general, if you guys want us to do like a trending topics blab, and I think the name of that particular segment will be Sniff and Sip. But whatever you guys want us to talk about, let us know. Expect at a minimum You found out because of James? Well, y'all know I love me some James now. And me and James, we cut the food together. You just joined in. Well, what I'll do, sis, is if you are not the host, what I can do is I can email you the link. Because if I host the blab myself, quote unquote, I can send you the link and you could just download it and upload it. You want a political blab? Now, if we do a political blab, I can't do it. And it's by virtue of what I do for a living. I cannot do political blabs, so. But that's the whole thing. So if you guys have any, it will get ugly, baby. health and wellness, what I'll try to do is I'll try to do a blab for next week. You're not doing politics? Okay. The health and wellness blab, I'll try to schedule that for the end of this month, for February, so towards the end of February. I'll try to do a health and wellness blab with other people involved. Expect a panel blab once a month at a minimum, but trying to do twice a month. And again, if you guys have topics, let us know. I know a lot of people was just saying, I want to see this. A religious, okay, you pushing it with the religious blab, baby. You pushing that one. That, it's doable, but I don't, it'll be difficult because things can go left. But if you guys have any topics, let us know. With your smartphone, I know if you have an Android, I'm pretty sure you can watch. It's hard to tune in with a Android phone. I know if you have iPhone, it is very, very easy to do it with an iPhone. So, I think that's pretty much all that there is. Like I said, I will do my best to keep you guys updated, posted, all that good jazz. It was a little difficult, okay. But the whole thing is just you guys just getting the chance to see all of us in a different light, because we all do our separate individual things, but us coming together, y'all get to see us live, real, in person. It isn't? Okay, so if you guys have Androids, then you have to do it for your computers, which is kind of sad. But the reality is anything that we do, that, like, because you'll see it in the description. If it says the panel, it will be uploaded to YouTube, regardless of what the fuck we talk about. Because the last one that we did, and it's on Alexander Rogers' page, I'm just going to put it out there. Go over there and watch it. If y'all have not seen it, your boy went the fuck off. I had some shit to say on that fucking blab, and I'm going to just say that. So, let's go ahead and get into the congrats, like the end of the video. I have two congrats that I want to go ahead and put out there. And I'm going to finish the little bit of tea. So hold on. One more swig and I'll be done. But before I go ahead and give the congrats, I do want to say, for everybody that tuned in, for those who have shared this on your Twitter with your followers and all the good jazz, thank you guys so much. I think we had a good time today. So, oh, I did. And here's the thing. When I say I drink a Long Island, my Long Islands are no fucking joke. Like, it's real shit, okay? And before I get to the congrats, if you guys do not know, I am a Scentsy consultant. I am on the Much Love from KY's team. So, I am a Scentsy man. If you guys want to purchase Scentsy, you guys can go to YARELL, my first name, .scentsy.us. And if you guys want to order from Scentsy, you guys can go ahead and do that. Just going to throw that out there. The whole bring back my bars, it ends tonight at midnight. So the old school bars, if you guys want those, that ends tonight. Just want to put that out there. So, in terms of congrats, Tamara Braxton, y'all know who Tamara is. She went to the White House for Michelle Obama's Reach Higher initiative. Okay. That's cool. She went to that, and she decided that she wanted to further her education. And to my understanding, she did not finish high school. So she wants to go and finish her education. So what I will say is, no matter what we say about Tamara Braxton, I'll say her name correctly, Tamar Braxton, congrats to you in furthering your education. And for Tara Banks, Tyra Banks, however you want to say her name, you know she has been having fertility issues. Well, she has had a baby boy, and what happened is, of course, they used her eggs, impregnated her egg with her boyfriend's sperm. I believe it's boyfriend. They're married. I don't know, but boyfriend, husband, sperm, and she had a surrogate. So they did have a baby boy. So congrats to Miss Tyra Banks, and also she's going to be on the Celebrity Apprentice. So congrats to Miss Tyra Banks. Stop it, James. So when this is all said and done, James, I will call you ever so quickly, talk to you, and once I'm done with all of that, I will transcribe this video. The shade will stop. If you guys watch me, I will be doing my Real Households of Atlanta and Potomac videos tonight. And Workout New York, if you guys have not watched my Workout New York videos, go back and watch those. Because the season finale is tonight. People from the show have been retweeting my links for the video. And I really do think I'm going to have to put my reading glasses on for Courtney. I didn't wear them last week, but I'm probably going to have to sit here and take Courtney to the water and then to the grave. So, that is all that I have. No, you keep your eyes on Courtney, James. So, that is all that I have, you guys. Thank you so, so much for watching. Y'all know we do this every Sunday, if my schedule allows it. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for sharing. I love you so much. Rate, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will see you guys next Saturday and on the next video. Yes, Courtney is gay. He is. He makes that very apparent. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.